Today, I'm gonna show how you can get one of the rarest sword that you can have in Elden Ring. And yes, I know what I'm talking about. You can get this sword only and only by completing Fia's questline. I already released a complete guide of how you can do that. That video is a little bit longer than this one. And if you want to find out more details, if you think the one that I'm about to do today is not good enough for you, don't worry, I'm gonna put a link in this video description with Fia's questline. But I'm gonna try to explain, and probably I'm gonna be the only one who will do that on YouTube to show you how you can get this weapon, because I'm gonna tell you from the start, you know, I never lie, so I don't want to make you stay here if you don't like to. This is gonna be a pretty complicated item to get, but the reward, it's pretty awesome, because the sword is looking absolutely amazing, and again, one of the rarest sword that you can have in this game. It's very powerful. It has a really good skill, the one that you are seeing right now, but also it has a really cool aspect. So the aspect of the sword, it's something else. Now, I have to admit, from when I just played the game for the first time, I never knew how to get this sword. Now I'm in the new game plus, and finally I've got it. You have to do a part of the Rani's quest, but I'm gonna explain that in a moment. After I just wanted to show you some of the how good is this sword. Definitely it's not the best sword in the game. Again, I don't want to lie about that, but it's something very good that probably you're gonna use a lot if you're gonna have it. The sword name, it's the Twin Sword or something like that. I hope I get the name right, and just look how it glows when you use the skill. And I think that damage is a holy damage. Also, the regular attack is pretty good. But again, I have to remind you, because I don't like to clickbait or something like that. Yes, I have something to explain very, very fast. You want to make an attractive title for people to watch your videos, but just attractive, not something like a lie. And for me, probably this is one of the rarest items that you can have in this game, because you will have to go through a lot to get it, and you have to not to miss a step. Definitely, I told you, I played a lot of this game. I have a lot of items. Some items may be hidden or secret, but this is something rare that you can barely have. That's why I decided to share with you this item, one of the most special items that I have in my inventory. Let's start. First, you're gonna find Fia for the first time, and you want to let her hold you. You're gonna find Fia for the first time at the round table hold. The next thing that you have to do, after you're gonna let her hold you, you'll have to find D. D, it's the twin brother of the one that we're gonna get the sword. D, it's that NPC with the beautiful armor. I'm gonna show you which one is D, but also you're gonna find D for the first time on a field. I have a video on my channel, definitely I have a video on my channel of how you can complete this quest line. You have to do the first part, and then if it will not be on this field, this is D. If it will not be on this field, you'll have to find D at the round table hold. At a certain time, it will be at the round table hold. Then you have to take a dead root that you... Okay, you're gonna get this little dialogue. Then you have to defeat this mariner. These are the steps, the quick steps. I just want to give the details. The death root that you want to give to this NPC, the ghost god, bro, I forgot the name of this one. I'm pretty sure you already know it. And then you have to make your way to the Grand Lift of Dectus to reach the Altus Plateau. This is a must. So just reach a site of grace from the Altus Plateau, because if you want to proceed with the Fia's questline, this is a must. Then go back at Fia's after you just reach that, and it will ask you, may I ask you a favor, and she's gonna give you the weather dagger. Again, you're gonna get this after you're gonna get to the Altus Plateau. The next step is to give the dagger to D right over here. This is D. It will stay at the round table hold if it's already there. So you just have to give him the weather dagger, and then you're gonna find D just dead right here in this room next to Fia. And very important, get his armor set. Without that, you cannot proceed with the quest, and never sold that armor, just keep it. Then the next step is to start Rani's quest, because now we're gonna need an item from the Rani's quest line. I told you this is the most complicated item to get, but I hope this explanation will be good enough. I hope I also have a video on my channel how you can complete the Rhynie's quest, but you have to do only the first part. The first part, when you defeat Radahn, it's a must. So you have to defeat Radahn. And the next step after you defeated Radahn, it will be for you to get a certain item for Rhynie's right over here in the Nokron Eternal City. Just teleport at Nokron Eternal City, get this Finger Slayer Blade. This very, very important item, the Finger Slayer Blade. Also, you're gonna get some bonus items from this all these locations, but we are here only to talk about that that sword. Now, you're gonna get a Kerian Inverted Statue. This is the item that you are looking for, because the next thing that we have to do is to go to the Kerian Inverted Tower or Kerian Tower right over here on the map, and then at that tower you're gonna get the Curse Mark of Death. Yes, these are the Site of Grace nearby, so just go to that study hall entrance right here, examine that I don't even know what is that desk, or yeah, examine that, and you're gonna put the Kerian statue, inverted statue that you just got from Rhynie's. Now just go ahead, make your way to the Curse Mark of Death. If you don't know how to make your way to this tower, don't worry, I already have a video with that. Just continue to reach the deep road depths. Now this will be the next location where your quest will end and where you want to get your sword from. Here at the deep road depths, you will find Fia for the last time before you finish her quest. And if you did everything like I just told you, then it's perfect because you are on the right path. Now just follow me until we're gonna find Fia. Let me show you the path from that Site of Grace, from the deep road depths Site of Grace. Okay, so this will be the Site of Grace, and after you're gonna reach this across the roots Site of Grace, you'll find Fia's champions. You'll find something like 5 of her champions, and you have to defeat those guys. Very important. This part it's a must, so again, don't skip. I died here once or twice, but don't worry, it's not a hard fight. Depends what is your level. So be prepared, summon your best spirit to defeat those guys. And I'm very sure that you're gonna make it. Okay, that was my finger blade. That was my bell ringing because I got my mimic tear. A very helpful mimic tear. And I have to repeat. I'm gonna repeat that during the video. If you have any trouble being here or doing something that I just mentioned, don't worry. In this video description, you're gonna find so useful. Some useful links to go and solve your mysteries, because I have the full Fia's quest line, but also I have the Rhynie's quest line that may help you, and the D's quest line again, it may help you. Now after you're gonna defeat those Fia's champions, you're gonna get this new Site of Grace, and you're gonna you have to rest here. You're gonna find Fia sitting next to those roots. Easy as that. Or hard as that, because yeah, it's not easy, I know. I told you it can be complicated, but don't worry, I'm very sure you can do it. Very sure. Talk with Fia right over here. And now just keep talking with her with the Death Mark of Death that you just got. Just go, no, I want to be held. Just go with that option, with no, I want to be held. Not the first one. You are not here to kill her. You are here to be held. So take the second option. If you take the first one, don't worry, you can switch over after. Talk with her again and just switch over. You wanna get a new dialogue, you can talk with her in secret.
Hmm.
And very fast you're gonna have the option to give her the course mark of that, the item that you just got from that Rani's item, with that Rani's item inverted statue from that tower. Give her the item, it's very important, and then rest at that site of grace again. Now, if you're gonna have some bugs here, don't worry, you can rest and talk with her, rest and talk with her until you're gonna get, by the way, you're gonna get this Radiant Baldakin blessing. You're gonna get this thing, and then rest at the site of grace, and now you can enter to her dreams to fight a big dragon. Very important that fight. Another must do. Fia is sleeping right now, but you're gonna go into her dreams or into her world, I don't know, to fight this Lich Dragon 40 sacks. A pretty tough fight, but I did it from the second try, I think, or third one, I don't remember. But if you focus enough, you're gonna defeat this dragon. Then after you just defeat that dragon, rest again at the site of grace. You're gonna go to your world, and let's see what Fia is doing right now. Yeah, as you can see, it looks like sleeping or dead. I don't even know, it's not dead yet. But take the rune, the mending rune of the dead prince. Obviously this video is gonna contain some spoilers with Fia's ending, so if you don't want to see what happens to her, just don't follow the next step, but I am very sure that you want to do that. Now this rune that you just got, or the item that you just got, it will unlock you a new ending. Now all you have to do is to go again underground to that Siofra River well, and to reach that let's see what is the name of the site of grace, the Ancestral Woods, right here. Go to this site of grace and just follow me, because now we have to reach the this brother. Finally you're gonna reach the this brother. I stayed here to turn out that light. Just keep going. It will be right over here at this aqueduct. I hope I pronounced that right again. And you'll have to give him the armor of his brother, the twinned armor set. That's why I told you it's very important to have that armor in your inventory, because you have to give him that armor set. It will be right over here sitting on this balcony. Hand over the twinned armor set. Yes. The armor, obviously, I wanted to show you the armor. This one is the armor. One of the most cool looking armor sets that you can have. You're gonna give him the armor, and the next step will be the final one. You have to go back to Fia's, where Fia's world was for the last time, and you're gonna find her dead with this brother at next to her body, and then he is gonna give you a dialogue. You can talk with him, but it's not very important. You can just attack him and get the sword. But I decided not to attack him, because yes, there is another option without attacking him. Just rest at that site of grace after you're gonna talk with him, and he will be gone, and you're gonna get the armor set, but also you're gonna get the sword. And this is the way of the complicated way. I know this is the complicated way of how you can get the sword. The armor, you can take it very early, but the sword, it's a pain in your tell me if there is another item that it's hard to get as this one. I don't think so. I told you I'd finish the game once, and I never found something harder to get than this sword. As I just told you, rest at the grace, and we're gonna get a new scene. He will be gone. and you're gonna take the armor and the sword. The inseparable sword is the name. Yeah, I think I told you at the beginning of this video the name of the sword is the twinned sword, but no, that is the name. I don't know how to pronounce that very well, so let's not watch me struggle again. Now let me show you some stats. As I told you, the shape is beautiful. It's made out of two metals, looks like silver and gold or something, or platinum and gold, looks like that, but definitely whatever it is, it's just beautiful. And with that holy damage, it's even better. Okay, the range is not that that huge on the skill, but the damage, it's perfect. I love it. Yeah, I really really like this one. Now, as I just promised you, I'm gonna show you the stats of this sword. Basically, this thing will build up with strength, dexterity, and faith. Faith is the most important ability that you need to have, and that holy damage is there. Let's see what are the other important things. The sacred blade is the unique skill that this sword has. Okay, the armament retains its holy essence for a while. Okay, so it can retain the holy essence for a while. I think basically it's the fact that it can stay gold for a while. I'm not sure, but yeah. Okay, that's it. Thank you so much for watching. You can hit that like button, subscribe, share, press that notification bell for more videos like this. You know, I'm your guy in Elden Ring. I have over 700 videos, or let's say 650 videos until now, with a lot of items, a lot of secret location, a lot of bosses, a lot of guides basically. So if you don't want to miss the next one, because I have prepared for you a lot more videos, you just have to press that notification bell. Also, if you enjoy my work, you can hit that like button, subscribe, share, and that's it. Thank you a lot. Be safe until the next time, and remember, if you want something in Elden Ring, just ask in the comments or watch on my channel, because you can find a lot of things. Bye. Just look at what I did to this doggy. Yeah, pretty powerful.